ಮಗುವಿನ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
Yes, sir.
Yes, teacher.
The same, ma'am.
Hi, children. Welcome to the English class of 8th standard, third language. I hope you all are ready with your belongings. Yeah, fine. Now, let us play a game. The name of the game is Who Am I? The name of this game is Who Am I? I am going to say few lines for you. You have to guess who am I. And your first task is here. Shall I read, children? Fine. I am a bird. I live in a pond. My babies are called ducklings. I am a bird. I live in a pond. My babies are called ducklings. Who am I? I think you are guessing. Okay. Let us check the answer. Yes. It is duck. I am duck. Okay. Now let us move to the second one. I am the national bird of India. I love to dance in rain. I am the national bird of India. I love to dance in rain. Who am I? Yeah, it is very easy. All of you got it. Yeah. I am peacock. Let's move to the third one. I am tall. When I am young, I am short. When I am old, who am I? I am tall. When I am young, I am short. When I am old, who am I? Don't get confused. Think. You can think over this. You use at your home also. Yeah, most of them, they have got it. Let us see. Yes, I am candle. Look here. When I am young, I am tall. As I grow old, I will become short. Isn't it? Okay, fine. Let us move to the fourth one. I have big round eyes, but I can see only at night. I have big round eyes, but I can see only at night. Who am I? You are thinking. Yeah, let us see what you have thought and the answer is right or wrong. Yeah, it is owl. I am owl. Okay, let us move to the fifth one. My color is white. My shape is oval. You have to break me before using me. My color is white. My shape is oval. You have to break me before using me. Who am I? Yes, absolutely right. I am egg. Fine, children. I hope you all have enjoyed this game. You can try this activity with your friends, with your parents, and with your neighbors also. Will you try this? Okay, thank you. Okay, children, let us move on to the lesson 3, Guru Nanak. Yeah, before moving to the today's text, let us recall few points which we have discussed in earlier session. Yeah, shall we? Okay. Guru Nanak was the first Guru of Sikhs. He was born on 15th April 1469, Talawandi, near Lahore. He was always thinking of God. We know Nanak was different from other children and always thinking of God. So, Mehta Kalu, his father, what he thought? He found a wife for Nanak. When Nanak was 14 years old, he got married. Even after they married, he didn't change. Same thing continued. So, his father again thought, I have to make my son busy. So, he gave some money to Nanak and told him to buy some goods, sell them and get profit. He agreed and he went to buy the goods. But on the way, he saw sannyasis who were starving. Then, the money what Mehta Kalu has given to Nanak, he gave that money to the sannyasis. And he helped the sannyasis. Sannyasis blessed Nanak. He came back and told to his father what had happened. Next, again his father fed up with this activity. So, Mehta Kalu sent Nanak to Nanaki. Nanaki was the elder sister of Guru Nanak. She was living with her husband in Sultanpur in Punjab. There Nanaki found a job for him. And all were pleased. All were happy with Nanak's work. Again after some time, don't know what came in his mind, he told his father to send Mardana to that place. Who was Mardana? Mardana was the servant. Shall we continue? What happened next? Okay, children, before going to the actual text, let us look into the new words which comes in today's text. Okay, fine. Today's first word, that is praise, which is in blue color. Praise means express warm approval. Express our warm appreciation. Express warm gratitude, respect. And our thoughts also. That is known as praise. Let us see the usage of word praise in the sentences. We praise God for blessings. Isn't it? We praise God for blessings. The teacher praises the boy. Look in the picture. The teacher. What is the teacher doing here? She is praising the boy for the work he has done. So, like this, we can make the usage of words in a sentences. Next, let us move to the next word. Hymn. Hymn means a religious poem. Hymn means religious poem, shlokas, we say, no? And, yeah, hymn means it's a religious poem. We sung the hymns with all our hearts. We sung the hymns with all our hearts. While we are offering prayer, we used to sing the hymns with all our hearts. In prayers, we recite hymn. Isn't it? During prayer, do we sing the songs? No, no. Do we make jokes? No, no. What we used to do? We used to recite the hymns to praise the God. Look here in the picture, the two children. See how politely they are sitting and they are singing hymns with all their hearts. Isn't it, children? Yeah. I know all of us will recite the rhymes in prayer to praise the God. Let us move to the third word, peasant. Peasant means a country person or a stick. Okay, let us see the usage of the word peasant here. The peasant is planting paddy. The peasant is planting paddy. Many peasants died during the drought. Isn't it so bad now? Many peasants died during the drought. Okay, let us move to the one more word, that is popular. Popular means famous, very familiar. Popular means famous and very familiar. Radha was one of the most popular girl, isn't it? When we hear the word Radha, suddenly we will recall Radha Krishna, isn't it? Radha was one of the most popular girl, and Lal Bagh is popular in Bengaluru. Everyone who visits Bengaluru, they want to go for Lal Bagh because it is the popular place in Bangalore. That is Bengaluru. Okay, children. Now, let us move to the actual text. What you are supposed to do here? You have to look at the screen. Pay your full attention and listen carefully. Okay? Okay, fine, children. Mardana was a Muslim. He was a good singer. Nanak used to write songs in praise of God. Every morning, he and Mardana sang these hymns together. Bala, a Hindu peasant, became Nanak's follower. He to join them in singing hymns. Many men and women came to listen to them. Nanak put all his ideas in his poetry. Soon, his songs of God became very popular. People sang them as their daily prayers. Okay, children. Now, what you are supposed to do is, again, I am going to read the text by dropping a word. The word which I drop, which I won't pronounce, you have to shout out that word. For example, Mardana was a, I'll say like that. You have to shout out Muslim like that. Shall we read the text once again? Both of us, let us read the text. Okay, fine, children. I am going to drop the word. You have to shout out that particular word. Fine, thank you. Mardana was a, very nice. He was a good, superb, children. Nanak used to write in praise of, every morning he and sang this together. Bala, a Hindu, very nice, became Nanak's superb. He to join them in singing, very nice. Many men and women came to listen to, Very nice children. You are doing very well. Nanak put all his superb in his soon his songs of became very people sang them as their daily. Very nice children. Okay, now let us comprehend the text what we have read right now. See, already we know that Mardana was a servant at Nanak's house in Talavandi. After coming to Sultanpur, Nanak, what he did, he told his father, Nanak told to Mehta Kalu to send Mardana to Sultanpur. Likewise, Mardana came to Sultanpur. Mardana was a Muslim and a good singer also. He was a good singer. So Nanak thought, began to write poems. Nanak began to write the poems on God. Okay, later Nanak and Mardana started to sing those poems. They were singing those poems in, yes, in early morning. They used to sing those poems in early morning. Nanak used to write songs in praise of God. What Mardana and Nanak used to do? Both Mardana and Nanak used to sing those songs. Then Bala, a Hindu peasant, you heard those songs and he joined with them and he became the follower of Guru Nanak. As day passed, poems became famous, very popular, the songs of God, and people used to listen them. Later those songs, and coming, Guru Nanak put all his ideas in poetry, and those poems become the songs of God. All men and women made the songs of God as their daily prayers. I hope you have understood the text. Shall I check your comprehension now? Thank you, children. Who was a good singer? Mardana was a good singer. Who became Nanak's follower? Bala became Nanak's follower. Who used to write songs? Guru Nanak used to write songs. Oh, now it's a time for grammar fun. In a square box you can see two letter word, that is. You all know, just let us have some activity on this. The word is, let us see where do we use is in a language. Okay. We use is when we speak about one person or one thing. We use is when we speak about one person or thing. Shall we see the examples? Okay. Meera is reading a book. The boy is sitting on a chair. He is a farmer. My pen is blue color. Fine, children. Now let us work with am. We use am only with I. Example, I am a doctor. I am reading a book. I am 6 years old. I am little girl. Thank you. Now let us move to the usage of are. We use are when we speak about one. Here focus on the word one. One means not one person, but only exemption is there. One, you. When we are speaking about, yes, second person singular. Yeah. At that time, we use the word R. Focus on you here, okay? And when we are speaking about more person, we use the word R. Let us see the usage of R in the sentences. There are 5 cups on the table. Sana and Reema are singing. The flowers are in the flower pot. Now let us see how we use with singular. Okay. You are a cute boy. You're amazing. Okay. Thank you, children. Now, here is an activity for you. Once I will read all the blanks. Later, you have to fill in the blanks using is, am, or. You have to see. Okay. I'll read out all the sentences once. I dash a teacher. They dash 7 days in a week. You dash a student. The boy dash playing. A bird dash flying. Deepu and Pawan dash friends. I dash going to school. I hope you're ready to give the answers for me. Okay. I am a teacher. Good. There are 7 days in a week. You are a student. The boy is playing. A bird is flying. Deepu and Pawan are friends. I am going to school. Good, children. Now, here is an activity for you which falls on page number 21 in your text. What you are supposed to do means 5 sentences I have given below. You have to fill those sentences with the words given above in a bracket. First, I'll read out the words. Herself, ourselves, themselves, himself, itself. Now, I will read the sentences for you. We solved the problems. Dash. No one helped us. He dash went to the police station to give a complaint. The old lady got up, dash, and crossed the road slowly. The cat licked dash clean. Rohini took the trouble to finish the work all by. Okay. Focus on the words. Herself. Okay. For feminine. Ourselves, including speaker, more than a one. Themselves refers to the group. Himself. Yeah. It is for masculine. Itself. Yeah. For animals, birds, singular, we can use. Okay. Let us see how you have written them. We solved the problems ourselves. No one helped us. He himself went to the police station to give a complaint. The old lady got up herself and crossed the road slowly. The cat licked itself clean. Rohini took the trouble to finish the work all by herself. We, including speaker, ourselves. He, for male, himself. The old lady refers to a female, herself. Cat, it refers to a, yes, yes, animal, bird or thing, itself. And Rohini, yes, again female, herself. Yes, well, children, you done this activity very nicely. Let us move to the one more activity. which has been given on page number 23. Yeah. Yes. See, here what we are supposed to do means we are supposed to fill in the blanks using must or mustn't. Must means we need to do. Mustn't means we are not supposed to do. Must means, yeah, we have to do the things. Mustn't means we should not do the things. It is on page number 23. Okay. I'll read all the sentences. One has done for you. You can see that. You dash play in the sun. Should we play in the sun? No, no. Yes, mustn't. What happens if we play in the sun? We will fall sick. So, the activities which we are not supposed to do, there we have to put mustn't. The activities which we need to do, there we have to write must. Okay. I'll read the rest of the blanks along with the sentences for you. You dash eat fresh fruits. It is good for health. You dash make noise in the library. You dash be late for school. Late for school. You dash read this book. It is very interesting. Leela dash apologize to her parents. She was rude with them. Shall I read once again? You dash eat fresh fruits. It is good for health. You dash make noise in the library. You dash be late for school. You dash read this book. It is very interesting. Leela dash apologized to her parents. She was rude with them. Yeah, you got idea what you have to do and what you shouldn't. Okay. One has already done for you. You must not play in the sun. You will fall sick. You must eat fresh fruits. It is good for health. You mustn't make noise in the library. You mustn't be late for school. Very nice, children. You must read this book. It is very interesting. Leela must apologize to her parents because she was rude with them. Good children, you have done a great job. Now it's time for assignment for you. Yeah. What you are supposed to do means you are supposed to write the gender of the following words. I will read out the words. You have to write the gender of father, wife, sister, uncle, man. I hope you are doing all your assignments what we are giving for you. Yeah, I am your teacher, Bibi Sahira. I hope you enjoyed today's class. Be home, be safe, and do all your works what all other teachers are allotting for you. Bye, children. Let us meet in a next class.
Anudina, anukshana, maniyellu kaliyona, kalikeya hossa hadiyali, jyotegoodi hecheya hakona, santasadi kaliyona, namma henviyai classinali.
Yes, sir.
Yes, teacher.
The same, ma'am.